We are here with Catherine from Heritage Action for America, and we're going to talk a little bit about now what happens at the state level, now that Roe v. Wade has officially been overturned. So just break this down a little bit. The justices have said that Roe v. Wade was wrongfully decided, but now that decision essentially just says that there is no constitutional right to abortion. It goes back to the states. What does that mean?
Yeah, it's really a historic moment because today really marks the beginning, you know, of this fight. It starts to say, hey, that power to regulate abortion or to say we're not going to allow abortion in our state really begins at the state level now. And in fact, you know, 26 states have already passed some type of legislation that protects life, which is incredible. But there's more work to be done in the states to ensure that unborn lives are saved and are protected. So this decision today gives states the ability to legislate those laws, to make those laws, and ensure that every unborn life is protected in the state.
And who are the leaders among pro-life states that have really set a good model and a good example of how to protect life?
Yeah, you've seen states like Texas, Oklahoma, Arizona, Florida pass heartbeat bills or pass legislation that even does a full restriction on abortion. You've also seen states pick up just this year, like Tennessee, regulating chemical abortion and making that, outlawing that in their state. And then you have states like South Dakota, Indiana, and Nebraska. Their governors or their legislatures have already said, when Dobbs, the ruling on Dobbs happens, we're going to call a special session and go back to work and say, how else can we make our state even more pro-life? So that's just incredible leadership by those states.
Yeah. And then as far as states that are very pro-abortion, what does the fight ahead look like in some of those states?
Yeah, it's sad, unfortunately, but you know, we saw California, I think even right now, pending in their legislature, an infanticide bill, a bill that says even after the baby is born, abortion is able. And we're seeing extreme measures in some of these blue states. And so Heritage Action, you know, we're fighting back. We're going to even go into those states. We're going to say, okay, what measures can we get across the line? And really that incremental approach. We're not going to stay silent, even in those states that say, hey, we're pro-abortion. We're not going to be silent. We're going to go in there. We're going to say, hey, how can we make this state even more pro-life?
So of course, the pro-life movement, today's a day of celebration. People are excited, but like we've been talking about, the fight isn't over. So for anyone in the pro-life movement who's thinking, okay, what do I do now? What's your advice to them?
Yeah, absolutely. I say get engaged. You know, there are multiple organizations that are working at the state level. Heritage Action is one of those. You can go to our website, heritageaction.com. You can get involved. We're registered to lobby in 16 states and more. There's multiple organizations that are committed to advancing pro-life legislation at the state level. And you can be a part of that. People can be a part of that by contacting their state lawmakers, giving testimony in committee, writing a letter to those lawmakers. And even at the federal level as well, there's still momentum to be done there. So.
Thank you so much for your time. We appreciate it.
Absolutely. Thank you.